الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن العزيز والفرقان الحميد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لن ينال الله لحومها ولا دماؤها ولكن يناله التقوى منكم كذلك سخرها لكم لتكبروا الله على ما هداكم وبشر المحسنين صدق الله العظيم. My dear respected brothers and elders, Alhamdulillah, it is a great blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has enabled us to gather here to perform Salatul Eid. This is Eid al-Adha, and on Eid al-Adha, the biggest and the most important amal is to give sacrifice, is to do the qurbani. This is why it's called Yawmul Udhiyya, the day of sacrifice. It is a day in which we relive and we bring to life the sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salam. What did he do? He went to fulfill the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which was to slaughter his beloved young son, which he got at very old age after requesting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a son for that many years. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him to sacrifice his son. And we all know that instead of sacrificing son, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced it with a sheep. And that sheep got sacrificed. But that amal and that action, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to be preserved until Yawmul Qiyamah. That every single Muslim who has the ability to give qurbani will do this action. Why? It's to show that number one, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be above everything. More than our parents, more than anything that we have in this world, the love of Allah should trump everything else. Everything. Nothing should stand in between love of Allah and him. And that is what is being taught to us by this amal. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be the most beloved, and it is his actions, or should we say his orders, should be followed upon. When we have true love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then to fulfill his orders will become easy. To fulfill his commands will become easy. This is why when it comes to spending on our family, our children, our wives, our parents, it is relatively easier than spending on others. Yes or no? If our child was to say, "Baba, could I have this toy?" A lot of the times we would go out and buy it. But if a poor man on the street was to ask us for that same £10, we think twice. Yes or no? But for the son, we straight away spent £10 and bought him that gift. We didn't think twice. If our parents were alive, or those who are blessed, who still have their parents alive, and they were to phone their son or their daughter, "So I wanted to, can you get me this particular thing?" Very rarely we would say no to them. Why? Due to our love for them. Due to our love for them. It becomes easy to make sacrifice for those to whom our love is there. It's easy to give our time and to give our wealth. Our health and wealth to spend on those beloved things is easy. It becomes easy. Likewise, my dear respected brothers and elders, when the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the greatest, then to spend and to fulfill his orders becomes much easier. Much easier. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to tell us through this amal. That the sacrifice that Ibrahim alayhi salam did was an action of a lover for his beloved. To show that Allah's love is above and beyond than everything else that we have in this world. Even if it means to sacrifice our own child, we would do. And that is what Ibrahim alayhi salam shown. And when we will inculcate such love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then my dear respected brothers and elders, waking up for Fajr will not become such a chore. Performing our 5-time salah will not become that difficult. Giving in charity will not become a second thought. Spend giving time for the sake of Islam, for our parents, for everybody else, will become easy. Although we have love for them, but sometimes it gets shaded by other demands that are put into our lives. But when we remember that who we are doing it for, are we doing it because we have a relationship? Are we doing it because what's society going to say if we don't? Or are we doing it because we want to fulfill the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we want to make him pleased. And then the deen becomes much easy. And to follow and to practice and to implement it into our lives, it doesn't become such an uphill task. And that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. He wants that we do it in a way that we are pleased to come and see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنْ أَحَبَّ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ أَحَبَّ لِقَاءَهُ وَمَنْ كَرِهَ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ كَرِهَ لِقَاءَهُ. Whoso loves and wishes to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes and loves to meet him. But on the other hand, those who fear and those who detest and those who are not prepared to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala due to their shortcoming, knowing that they are on the wrong path, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala detests to seeing them. My dear respected brothers and elders, once it has been established that this is part of deen, then we do it wholeheartedly. Just like this qurbani. This qurbani that we do. One may say, why spend 100, 200 pounds? Why don't we just give it to charity? My dear respected brothers and elders, this qurbani has taught us that lesson. That our own intellect should not interfere in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed. Once it has been established that this is the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we accept it wholeheartedly. We understand or not understand. When Ibrahim alayhi salam knew that this was the order and the wishes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he didn't question what is the reason behind it? What is the understanding behind it? I need to know what is the science behind it. No, once it's been established that is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who am I to try to kind of challenge his order? That's the mentality that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants, because he knows our fallacies, he knows our limitation, he knows our weaknesses. To delve into that matter would lead us astray, because we don't have all the information to come to that right judgment all the time. Because we can only come to a judgment to whatever limited knowledge that we have. What you put into the computer, that's what will come out. What the computer doesn't have, what it cannot give. So what limited knowledge we have, based on our knowledge, that's the answer that will come out. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows we don't have the full knowledge to understand all this. That capability has not been given to us, or nor can it be. Because our time is so short in this world. We have limited time, so our knowledge will be limited. Remember, our power, our time, everything is limited. That equals limited knowledge. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his time, his power is limitless, then his knowledge is also limitless. Once we understand that, then to follow the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes easy. And that is what Ibrahim alayhi salam shown. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered to slaughter my son. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's order. He gave the son, he told me to do it, I will do it. Because everything what we do is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is it for? قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, say, proclaim, have it in your heart. تَقُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي, my salah, وَنُسُكِي, my sacrifice, everything what I do, my life, وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي, my death. Who is it for? It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when everything belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to us, then that means He has entrusted with us and He has told us what to do with it. When somebody gives you something and entrusted you something, then you cannot do whatever you want with it. You're entrusted. You do what you have been entrusted with, whatever the direction, use it for this, not for this, then we do it. So my dear respected brothers and elders, today's lesson is what? Is that once the hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been established, then we accept it wholeheartedly and practice upon it. And our success will lie in that. Just like Ibrahim alayhi salam has shown us that the success is in the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though it may appear different. Can you imagine being told to sacrifice your own son, such a beloved son, and a son that is started to walk, started to crawl, started to do things, he's got up, now is the time when he can help, he can become a member of the family that can help, and then being told to slaughter. How difficult that could have been. How difficult that could have been. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذِ ابْتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنَّ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran that He knew that this was a test that me and you, nobody could have done. But He has shown that no, my love for my children, for my family, for my wealth is non-existent compared to the love for you. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. And when we can inculcate and create such love, then believe me, practicing on the deen will not be so difficult as it seems today. We will not find it so hard. It is time for salah. We ain't even in the market. We will look for a place to pray our salah. We will look for a place. Not, you know what, I'll read it when I go home. That's for those people who actually read the salah. They go home and read it even if it means qaza. My dear respected elders, where there's a will, there's a way. I can remember my father, right at the beginning, he had two jobs right at the beginning. First, he used to work for American Life Insurance Company during the day, and the evening he used to work in a Ford company. It was that time when my father got sent by Mujib's government at that time to work in the embassy. So he came, sent by the government to work in the embassy. He used to work in the embassy, and then, as you know, he got assassinated. Then the new government came and they wanted to bring their employees. So my father literally was out of a job. But because he knew English, so to cut the long story short, is that he was doing two jobs at that time. So he's working during the day for American Life Insurance Company because he knew English, so he was working there. And during the evening, he used to work in Ford company. So alhamdulillah, by that time he had gone into Jamaat, he going to Tabligh, he transformed his life. When he first came, clean shaven, smoking cigars because in the embassy is free. You know, if you see my father that time, subhanAllah, you can't imagine, suit and tie and everything. But then afterwards, from 1975, he went to Tabligh and he got He was had worry and concern about his deen. So while he was working in the factory, he said, you know what? There's so many Muslims here and nobody's performing Jummah. What's happening? Then he went and asked his foreman, said, look, we need to perform our Jummah. He got four people ready. You know what? We're going to perform Jummah. Foreman said, wait, there's all this machinery work going on. How are you going to perform? Because I found a space. Just let us pray there. And it's just right in one place, small little place. And Foreman said, okay, go. So he started Jummah. When he left the company actually designated a place, and there was over 500 to 600 people performing Jummah when he left the company. 500 to 600. Nowadays, you go to companies, they have places to perform Salah. The reason why is that when you go on that path, Allah Ta'ala makes it easy. You can go to airports and you can find places to play to perform your Salah. It wasn't like that before. I can remember when the Tablighi Jamaat, they would come in and they would just start praying the Salah. I said, what's this? This is hazard, yo. You can't have people doing this. So we need to pray. And slowly you start getting places where they're, okay, we'll give you a place to perform. Now, alhamdulillah, it's there. The work has been done. Every four corners you see massages. Somebody did the foundation somewhere. My dear respected brothers and elders, wherever there's a will, there's a way. If you do it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will start opening doors. And then you would leave such a legacy that you would die. But alhamdulillah, the reward is continuously going into your grave. That's what we want. We want to leave a legacy whereby the Muslims of the next generation will benefit of the fruits of our efforts. And we can only leave a legacy if we're doing it ourselves. If we're not doing it ourselves, what hope is there that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give you tawfiq to do something like that? You can't think, you know what, I'm going to do something fantastic and Allah's going to forgive me everything. No. It doesn't work like that. Allah is not in need of me and you. We have to show that we in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is why, my dear respected brothers and elders, the sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam is there to remind us that the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be the greatest. And on this point, I will also want to inform, or should I say, educate people that the amal of sacrifice is the most important amal on this day. So we should all, those who have the ability, not at least do one. But what I see now is people being so lazy that in the house they have 4 or 5 qurbanis, not even one is being done here. All said, you know what, we've got money, just chuck the money and we send it to abroad. Who wants to do this headache? Pick up your credit card, phone some company and let's give it. That's the attitude we are doing. Our children are not seeing this amal of qurbani, this sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salam is not being relived within our families. The children could see the meat coming home, and I can remember my father used to bring it. We said, what is this about? Oh, this is what it is. This is the sacrifice done on this day. Partaking, this is sunnah. How many of us get to eat qurbani meat? Very rare now. Alhamdulillah, many of us are giving qurbanis. We're giving 8, 9, 10, we're giving charity 3, 4, alhamdulillah, it's all well and good. But doing in our homes, why is it that we've forgotten this? Alhamdulillah, all of us are capable of giving qurbanis. There's maybe 5 qurbanis that is a Jew or his family. We have 3 children, 4 children, everybody's working, everybody's giving qurbanis. Alhamdulillah, very good. But how many is doing one? Okay, what can we just say, okay, we'll do one here, or we'll give 4 abroad. One, we do it as a family. Bring the family together. Let the children see. Have the Qurbani Sunnah. How many of us are able to perform this Sunnah? We lose this Sunnah. Slowly, slowly everything's going away. Because we don't have time. The people can't even take day off nowadays for Eid. Because they don't plan. I know brothers who today can't take the Eid because they didn't book in advance. So they're working. This is our negligence. This is how we feel important toward Deen. My dear respected brothers and elders, this is the Sunnah of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it such that it should be relived every single year. So this is why we should do it here. In our family, at least one, there's 5-6 of us whom upon Qurbani is wajib, give one here. Do it here, have the barakah. Also, distribute it, give it to your friends and family. Nowadays we have a lot of refugees, give it to them as well. There are a lot of people who don't have any source of income, give them as well. No, but we don't. Because we're too busy. Too busy, as if we're going to take all this wealth into our graves. We've got a contract with Allah, we're going to take it with us. And then we're going to buy our Jannah with it. That's not how it works. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all tawfiq, inshallah. Inshallah. Brothers, please, if you can, donate, inshallah, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the masjid, inshallah. Again, this is also a sacrifice, sacrificing our wealth for ourselves, not for anybody else, for ourselves. This will go into our own akhirah in the hereafter. And like I said, if you still have the opportunity, you haven't got one, Qurbani is done for 3 days. Talk to somebody, talk to any butcher. That can we do on the last day? Can we do another day? You know, I've just heard that it's important that we do it. I haven't done it. Let me go and talk. Who knows? I know so many brothers who are doing Eid tomorrow. They're doing the sacrifice tomorrow. Maybe you can join them and give Qurbani then tomorrow, if you haven't done it today. But don't forsake the Sunnah. Don't make it a habit. Because what we do, our children are going to follow. Our children will follow. It's very wrong. This Sunnah is being taken out from our lives due to our negligence. And sometimes we think, you know what? If I have to do it here, it's going to cost me 250. And if I do it abroad, it costs me 90 quid or 100 quid. You know, that kind of mentality. My dear respected brothers and elders, this is what I talk about, love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can't even spend money. And even then, the meat that we're going to enjoy, even we're going to enjoy it, still we can't give it. Then what hope do we have? Subhanallah, every time I hear this music, it riles me up. I don't know why. So many times I've said it in Jummah, please, my dear brothers, do not bring music into the masjid. Just change the tone of your phone. Keep it simple. Why do we have James Bond? Why the Mission Impossible? Why do we have all these ringtones? I don't understand. Why? Subhanallah. And then even worse, you know what? I'm going to make it. I'm going to put Qari Basit on it. That's even worse as well. Imagine you go to the toilet and then Alif Lam. Subhanallah, you listen to Qiraat in the toilet now. We don't realize. Or if you got Azan, Allahu. What's happening here? Your toilet azan is going on. Just keep a simple ringtone to notify you that you have a call coming. That's all you need. You don't need to have a music that you can dance to every time it comes. You don't need all that. Nor do you need to be told which is Surah Baqarah or Surah Yasin. No need all that. There's a place and time for all that. We all know that speaking in the toilet is detestable, let alone listen to Quran. Yes or no? Or is it where we do all our business dealings and everything? In America, they call it the restroom. This is where you sit down, you rest, you start thinking, you think about the next move. What are you going to do? They have, was it magazines in the toilet? Pick up the magazine. Ah, subhanAllah, you're in the toilet. It's called the restroom now. And that's what's happening. Because it's so busy, they don't have time. The only time they get is in the toilet. The only time they get is in the toilet. Then they get the, now you obviously take the phone. So you take the phone out. Right. Check my emails. This is the time to check my emails out. That's it. And that's what's happening. This is what's happening. This is the reality, my dear respected brothers. So I request all brothers, please. This is not the topic. But I heard music in the masjid. And I have to say it again. As a reminder, وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. That reminding brothers benefits the believers. So again, I request, humbly request, all brothers, that change your ringtone. Just keep a simple ringtone just to notify you. Ding, ding. You heard that one before? Or is that gone now? That ring, ding is gone. It's not, it doesn't even exist anymore, does it? Well, let me remind you. Ding, ding. That one. That's enough. And that will remind you, inshallah. So brothers, inshallah, if you can all stand up, inshallah, and we will perform 2 rakat salatul Eid with 6 extra takbir. And inshallah, when the imam says Allahu Akbar, we raise our hands and then we fold it, and then after, before the qiraat, the imam will say Allahu Akbar, we raise our hand to the earlobes and let it drop. Second time we will say Allahu Akbar, we raise our hand to the earlobes and let it drop. The third time imam will say Allahu Akbar, then we will fold our hands as we normally do in our salah. Then the imam would complete the raqah, first raqah, as he would complete in Salatul Jumu'ah. And then after that, in the second raqah, after reciting qira'at before going to ruku', the imam would say Allahu Akbar, raise our hand towards the earlobes and let it drop. Again, we will say Allahu Akbar, raise our hand towards the earlobes and let it drop. The third time we will say Allahu Akbar, raise our hand towards the earlobes and let it drop. And the fourth takbir, we will go into ruku' and complete the raqat as we will complete our raqat in the second raqat in Salatul Jumu'ah. After that, the imam will do khutbah, and then we should, after they listen to the khutbah, inshallah, everyone is free to go.
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. Malik Yawmiddin. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا عامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. الله أكبر ولله الحمد. اللهم لك الحمد كما أنت أهله، وصل على محمد كما أنت أهله، وافعل بنا ما أنت أهله، إنك أهل التقوى وأهل المغفرة. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة، إنك أنت الوهاب. يا فاطر السماوات والأرض، أنت ولينا في الدنيا والآخرة، توفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين، غير خزايا ولا مفتونين. اللهم ارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. اللهم اغفر لجميع موتى المسلمين. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية والمعافاة في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم إنا نسألك إيمانا كاملا ويقينا صادقا ولسانا ذاكرا وقلبا خاشعا وتوبة نصوحا وتوبة قبل الموت وراحة عند الموت والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. يا عزيز يا غفار، يا رحيم يا جبار، يا كريم يا ستار، اللهم عجلنا وخلصنا من النار. اللهم عجلنا وخلصنا من النار. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله، ما علمنا منها ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك منه نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك منه نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. وأنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الحمد لله الذي جعل لكل أمة منسكا ليذكر اسم الله على ما رزقهم من بهيمة الأنعام، وعلم التوحيد وأمر بالإسلام. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر. الله أكبر ولله الحمد. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله الذي هدانا إلى دار السلام. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. الله أكبر ولله الحمد. صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الذين قاموا بإقامة الأحكام،
وبذلوا أنفسهم وأموالهم في سبيل الله فيا لهم من كرام وسلم تسليما كثيرا. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد. أما بعد، فاعلموا أن يومكم هذا يوم عيد شرع لكم ما فيه مع أعمال أخر قد سبقت في الخطبة قبل هذا العشر، ذبح الأضحية بالإخلاص وصدق النية، بين نبيه وصفيه صلى الله عليه وسلم وجوبها وفضائلها، ودون علماء أمته من سننه في كتب الفقه مسائلها. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد. فقد قال عليه الصلاة والسلام: ما عمل ابن آدم من عمل يوم النحر أحب إلى الله من إحراق الدم، وإنه ليأتي يوم القيامة بقرونها وأشعارها وأظلافها، وإن الدم ليقع من الله بمكان قبل أن يقع بالعرض، فطيبوا بها نفسا. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد. وقال أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: يا رسول الله، ما هذه الأضاحي؟ قال: سنة أبيكم إبراهيم عليه السلام. قالوا: فما لنا فيها يا رسول الله؟ قال: بكل شعرة حسنة. قال: فالصوف يا رسول الله؟ بكل شعرة من الصوف حسنة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: من وجد سعة لأن يضحي فلم يضحي فلا يحضر مصلانا. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد. وقال ابن عمر رضي الله تعالى عنهما: الأضاحي يومان بعد يوم الأضحى، وعن علي مثله. وهذا بعض من الفضائل، وتعلموا من العلماء المسائل. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: لن ينال الله لحومها ولا دماؤها ولكن يناله التقوى منكم، كذلك سخرها لكم لتقبلوا الله على ما هداكم وبشر المحسنين. بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم، ونفعنا بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم. أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه، إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الله أكبر الله أكبر، الله أكبر الله أكبر، الله أكبر الله أكبر، الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله، أرسله بالحق بشيرًا ونذيرًا بين يدي الساعة. من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد، ومن يعصهما فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئًا. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك، وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات، وبارك على محمد وأزواجه وذريته. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر، وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر، وأصدقهم حياء عثمان، وأقضاهم علي، وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة، والحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة، وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسوله رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. اللهم اغفر للعباس وولده مغفرة ظاهرة وباطنة لا تغادر ذنبا. الله الله في أصحابه
أصحابي لا تتخذوا مغرضا من بعدي، فمن أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم، ومن أبغضهم فبغضي أبغضهم، وخير أمتي قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. اللهم أعز الإسلام وأنصاره، وأذل الشرك وأشراره. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى، واجعل آخرتنا خيرا من الأولى. اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم، واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون، فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون. الله أكبر الله أكبر، 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 لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد. السلام عليكم.